Hi guys, NAMM 2020, we are in an oasis of peace and quiet with Danelectro. I'm with Danny, man. Listen, you've done the right thing. Listen to how lovely and soft and lovely and quiet
this
is.
It makes life worth living.
You're not kidding. You're not kidding, yeah. Seriously, I'm really super happy to be here. For a variety of reasons, because you've got a bunch of cool new guitars, a bunch of really exciting new pedals.
Yes.
Do you want to talk us through the range?
Sure. This is the 59 Divine. And Divine it is. Back in the 60s, they made them with the they made this model with the walnut top, and so they kind of recreated it with upgrades. Though we have a intonatable bridge, bone nut, which is the tuning is much better, and these are pickups. They're the vintage 50 pickups, which they took the 50s Danelectro pickups, took them apart totally, took them and copied them exactly. Getting the old magnets made, the wiring, so it's just it became huge.
Oh, that's nice.
It just came out. It's bell-like. Pickups is they're just open, they're just big and open, more low end, and just happy. They're great vintage 50s,
really nice. And that's on all guitars?
No, that's it. Yeah. It's called the 59 Divine, which we have the walnut top, and there's a cream and a flame maple.
Very cool. The cream's gorgeous.
Yeah.
That's my favorite. It's really, really nice.
Yeah.
I mean, they all look great, but that's
really sexy. Yeah. So this just sounds, it came out better than we thought. It's just big. Everybody's freaking out, man.
It sounds wicked. Sounds really, really cool. Yeah.
So that's that one, huh?
Yeah, absolutely, man. Do you have some more guitars you want to talk about?
No, let's get the pedals. Let's get the pedals.
All right, so one I think everybody's really excited about is the back talk.
Okay.
Because there is history behind this. I'm not going to butcher it. I'll let you explain.
Okay.
But it's a reverse delay. But it's the reverse delay.
It's a new reverse delay, but it's a recreation of the original. Danelectro did the original.
Yeah.
Back talk.
Yeah.
Back in the 70s probably 80s, I guess. This is the exact recreation of that.
Yeah.
Because the new ones are, I mean, if you buy the old ones, they're really expensive. Trying to find them.
Yeah. Well, they're all in studios all around the world, aren't they?
They're like $400 or $500. So anyway, but Steve was involved with the first ones. I mean, it's not just he's recreating, copying somebody else's thing.
This is the same guy, same engineer.
Yeah, same guy. Man.
Wow.
Same guy. Okay. So that's the vibe with this thing. Okay, and we found with the reverse delay, which you wouldn't think is a cool thing to do, is like just a little slapback.
Okay.
But you get the little slapback, but you get the reverse. It kind of does this funky thing, man.
All right.
So it gives it that. It's like psychobilly, I call it.
Psychobilly.
Okay.
We like that.
But then we got this. This is a whole different thing right here. Okay, so. After he took the purple haze. So it just. If you turn the mix all the way up is kind of cool, where you don't get the first note.
Yeah.
It's just the delay, and you can get really crazy with that. It'll go on forever.
I love that. So let's talk about the second pedal in line. Okay. You knocked that on when we're playing with back talk.
Yep.
Tell us about what we got going on here.
Okay. This is the Roebuck, which is a copy of the Ibanez Mustortion, basically.
Okay.
Which is a pedal that, just like these other pedals, has become a sought after vintage pedal.
Yeah.
You know, it's on almost all of the session guys, you see it on their board. They go, oh,
interesting.
I haven't seen that before. So it became a thing.
So it's like a trade secret, you know?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So it's a big, crunchy, fat. Dynamic too with it. Turn it down a little here with your pick, just not hitting as hard.
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah. And of course, we've got the first was the 3699, and this is based on the Foxtone machine. Excellent.
And
really cool.
And I don't know if you know, but actually, Steve, who owns Danelectro, mm-hmm. Fox was his company.
Oh, really? Okay. So it's the same guy.
Same guy.
So it's not.
He made that pedal, the original.
Wow.
So this is a recreation of that.
Excellent. So it's like.
So it's the same.
Super
thing.
Authentic in that case.
Exactly.
Then.
Exactly. Then we have the, with this, turns on the octave.
Okay, sweet. That's killer. And it's like, it's one of those octaves, it's a little different to, you know, people are familiar with an Octavia.
Yeah,
it works, it's a lot more pronounced, it works all the way up and down the fretboard.
Right.
So this is different to the Eisenhower. The Eisenhower is like, was it based on the Super Fuzz? Is that right?
Super Fuzz, yeah. It's a little different. This is more retro. This was like just kind of that more funky old. Yeah.
It's very cool.
And then with the, another thing with the octave, in the front pickup, I turned it on in the front pickup, it gives it, you get a lot more pronounced octave. If you have it in the back, if you don't want that much, you just go to the back with it.
Really cool. And it's like, it'll do that thing, I'd imagine, where you can roll the octave in with the tone control. So as you roll the tone back,
the octave gets more, it comes up more.
Very cool. Exciting stuff.
Looking
forward to getting some of the test bench, man.
Great, man.
Danny, thank you so much.
Awesome, Nick.
Killer stuff from Danelectro. Our NAMM 2020 coverage continues. We've got to go back into the loud now. I just want to stay here, but never mind. Into
Come
the loud we go. Absolutely. Thank you so much, man.
All right, buddy.
Appreciate it.
All
thank
right,
you.
Man. All right.